नाउ वी विल सी इन डिटेल व्हाट इज द व्हाइट टाउन ब्लैक टाउन. बिफोर 1665 मद्रास वॉज नॉट अ रेसिडेंसी टाउन, इट वॉज सबॉर्डिनेट टू द सूरत. द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव हेड वॉज कॉल्ड एज अ एजेंट. He had to administer settlements with the help of a council. The agent and the members of his council were given work to administer civil and criminal justice to the inhabitants, citizens of the White Town, and the serious criminal cases were often referred by them to the company's authorities in England for advice. Means in the White Town, the head is called agent. And he had to administer the settlements with the help of a council. Serious criminal cases were often referred to the company's authorities in England for advice. There were many defects in the judiciary. The cases which were not that much serious that also were suggested to the company's authorities in England. This included time pass and delay for judgment. The members of the council were to administer justice were merchants and not lawyers. Means those who were given the responsibility to deliver justice or to fight on the behalf of the people were the merchants, laymen. They were not the lawyers. They were supposed to decide the cases according to the English law. But actually, they did not have even elementary knowledge of the English law. According to their intelligence, wisdom, thinking capacity and mentality, the judgments were delivered and there was no separation of judiciary and executive. Means these people were laymen and then they were not having the elementary knowledge. According to their conscience, intelligence, they were giving justice. Next is the Black Town. The old judicial system was allowed it to function. There was a village headman known as Adhigar or Adhikari. In White Town, the head is called agent. And in the Black Town, the head is called Adhigar or Adhikari. Who was responsible for the maintenance of a law and order. Adhikari administered justice to the natives at the Chowdhury court. The black towns were having Chowdhury court according to the long established uses. The Chowdhury court with the Adhikari as the judge was to decide the small civil and criminal cases. The Chowdhury court was a court of petty cases. It was not to hear the cases of grave offense which were committed by the natives. Even the agent in the council had no express authority from the larger to decide them. They had to take the permission direction from the Raja, such cases to be decided according to the English laws. The company had no power to inflict death sentence under the charter of 1600, and therefore the agent in council could inflict such a sentence only under the authority of the local servant. Means here we see that under the charter of 1600, the agent was not having the right to give anybody death sentence. If there is an authority of the local servant is present there, then only the agent in council can give the death sentence with his permission. The appeals from the Chowdhury court were to be heard by the agent in council. Adhikari who misused his power and so on, he was dismissed from the office. The English servants of the company were appointed to sit at the Chowdhury courts. This is about the Black Town. So now we will see the defects of the Chowdhury court. So there was no fixed procedure for the trial of serious criminal cases, and the procedure varied from case to case. The judge of the Chowdhury court was a layman and not a lawyer. The Chowdhury court could decide only small civil and criminal cases. it was not empowered to decide serious criminal cases like murder, etc. There was no separation between the executive and judiciary. The agent and the council constituted both the executive and the judicial authority. They were to hear appeals from the Chowdhury court and also to decide the cases of a grave offence according to the English law on the express commands of the Raja. So these are the defects of the Chowdhury court. Next is the Mayor's Court. In 1688, a corporation and a mayor's court were established at Madras under the charter of 1687. In 1688, a corporation and a Madras court, both were established at the Madras under the charter of 1687, issued by the East India Company and not by the British Crown. Means these things are established by the East India Company, EIC. In this, there is no interference of the British Crown. There were several reasons for the establishment of such court. The Madras court had levied a house tax, which was opposed by the Hindus in the Black Town, by restoring to strike methods such as abandoning their duties, shutting up their shops, etc. The company decided to set up an corporation to the Madras, so it will be easy to collect tax. Means for collecting tax, the corporation was established. The corporation includes both Indians as well as Britishers. The company thought that by setting up such corporation of the caste leaders appointed as aldermen and burgesses would be ready to tax themselves. Such corporation was established at the Madras in 1688. Means the company thought that if we appointed the caste leaders, those who are of the religious communities, if such leaders came in our company, then as aldermen and burgesses, then the people will be ready to pay the tax. So such corporation was established at Madras in 1688. Aldermen, magistrate, collector, a person governing kingdom, district, etc. Aldermen means magistrate or a collector, and burgesses means the citizen of the British Crown or the citizen from the White Town. Citizen of the British Crown or the citizen of the White Town is known as burgesses. So the corporation consists of a mayor, 12 aldermen, 60 or more burgesses. Mayor and 3 senior aldermen were always to be convenated means contract, British servants of the company, and the remaining 9 aldermen could belong to any nationality. 30 of the 60 burgesses were to be the head of several castes. The first mayor, aldermen, and 29 burgesses were appointed by the company. Aldermen and burgesses were nominated by the governor and governor's council. The whole and sole power was vested in the governors and the councillors, and they were empowered to appoint and remove them. Along with the corporation, the charter of 1687 issued by the company created a mayor's court also. Means with the corporation, mayor's court was also established, and the mayor's court was the part of this corporation. The mayor and the aldermen were to constitute a court of record, which was known as mayor's court. Means mayor's court is also known as court of record. The mayor and the 3 of the aldermen were to be the justice of the peace. The judge of the mayor's court were laymen and not experts in law. Means the judge of the mayor's court were laymen and they were not the experts in the law. Laymen means merchant. And therefore, a provision was made in the charter for the appointment of an expert in the law as a recorder to assist the judge of the mayor's court in deciding cases. Sir John Biggs, the judge advocate of the Admiralty Court, was appointed the first of the mayor's court, Sir John Biggs. The mayor and the 2 aldermen constituted its quorum. The mayor's court was empowered to hear and decide the civil and criminal cases. It was also authorized to punish offense by corporal punishment. Now, what are the punishment given by the mayor's court? Corporal punishment, imprisonment and fine. It was to decide cases according to justice and good conscience and laws enacted by the company. In civil cases where the value of the case was more than 3 pagodas, 1 pagoda is equal to 3 rupees in Indian currency, and criminal was sentenced to lose life or lost cases where the offender appeals from the mayor's court lay to the court of admiralty. When after 1704 the court of admiralty ceased to sit regularly, appeals from the mayor's court lay to the governor and council. After 1712 it was clear that the mayor's court could award death sentence in the cases of natives, Indians, but it could not award death sentence in the case of Englishmen. Means here we see that mayor's court started to give death sentence to the Indians in cases, but it couldn't award the death sentence in the case of Englishmen. So this is the system of the mayor's court. And next is the defects of the mayor's court.